Welcome back, guys, to a special progress video, Mr. Iron Bar. So this one is basically a sequel to one of my other progress I did, involving a lot of collection logs. We did a lot of temporos before and medium clues, but this video is going to be a very wide variety. We're going to greenlock a bunch of things as well. So lots of clues, lots of mini game stuff, and lots of bossing as well, on top of our normal progress. So crazy packed collection log video for Mr. Iron Bar. So if you guys enjoy this type of content or just general progress, definitely consider following and subscribing to the channel, because we got some big content coming out as well, new bosses coming up, and you know I'm going to be there because there's some good bets and slots. We'll talk more about that in the future, but enjoy the video. Oh my god, evil chicken legs. You actually can get dupes? That's actually dumb. So there's this mini game called Shooting Stars that is basically almost a copy of the original Shooting Stars from the original game, where you mine meteorites to fall at random places in the game. So in this version of our game, we get this thing called Stardust, and we can purchase stuff with it. And one of the rewards is the Celestial Ring that you can add to a Elven Signet. And this ring is really nice because it gives you a +4 invisible mining boost, so it can be pretty handy at times. And I like getting best in slot items, so I might end up using it a lot if I need, I don't know, to mine more Amethyst or Gardens of the Rift or something like that. It is worth it, and it's a collection log slot. You can also get double ore if you charge the ring with more Stardust, but I don't really need that one. The +4 mining boost is what's up, and that you have forever, regardless if you charge it or not. Oh yeah, it is. Sweet, that's a collection log item, but I'm just gonna use it. I'll probably do more of these on my free time. Cool. Nice. One of them is golden now. Before the video continues further, I just want to say Happy New Year's for those of you watching the video at the start of the release and wondering what kind of goals you guys have for this year. And if you guys interested in maybe getting a new job perhaps, or learn a new skill, if so, I got just the right sponsor for you guys. Digital gaming has reached a mainstream audience over the last decade. This is great news for those of us who love games and have thought about making a career out of making them. For example, even Manked Up Mage recently got the job for a content developer role for Jagex. He was the 2-time Demon World Tournament winner. I want to proudly introduce you to today's sponsor, Southern New Hampshire University. SNHU is one of the biggest accredited institutions that offer online degrees in the United States. Their game development program is perfect for those of you that want to explore an exciting field with endless possibilities. Their program will cover various important aspects of video games, such as creating an immersive game experience using game AI, game physics, 2D and 3D graphics, and interface design. You'll also learn 3D modeling and texturing with gaming art software. SNHU has one of the most affordable tuitions. If this offer sounds amazing to you, then head over to their website by clicking on the link snhu.edu/ricecup to see the average annual salary a programmer can make and ask about their program. A real representative will happily discuss how their program can benefit you in detail. You're just one click away from potentially discovering your favorite IRL skill. I forgot to open this. Hey, everything's good again, boys. Hell yeah, easy. Oh wow, that's so quick. Ooh, another easiest slot. 6:15 already. Look at that. All right, we got a few clues to open today. First one, elite. Oh, yo! Holy shit! 2 slots just like that, bruh. That's actually sick. Oh wait, 3 uniques already. Black demons. Ooh. What is it called? Glau's experiments. Yep. Not a single one of these. So I have actually gotten every single demonic gorilla unique on this account, but that was years ago before the log came out. So I guess we can try again, except we have way better gear this time, so it'll be a lot quicker. I haven't really been using the site that much, so I figure it'd be fun to use that demonics. But some of the specialties is Discharge, Lightbearer, so that way I can basically have unlimited specs, so I can just keep spamming the Sarah God Sword for prayer back and HP back if I ever make mistakes, which I totally will. So chill. Oh, Zenithsword! Oh, let's go! Yes, first new item, eh? On the collection. Right, let's go. Alright, let's go open this. Oh, easy. That's gotta be like... Yeah, that's one slot right there. Nice. Very nice. And we got an elite casket. Boring. Dang it, I was gonna SG spec. Oh, Ballista Limbs, let's go! Hell yeah, let's go. Easiest dopamine of my life, you know? Oh, another one, holy! Well, we're pretty much done with this task, that was pretty quick. Alright, there we go. Here is Fang, post-nerf at the Mythril Dragons. Ooh, Hellhound's sick. Alright, we can do Cerberus. We still need to get that Eternal Crystal, and then we get the green log, and we can forget about it. There we go. Oh, Eternal! Oh my god, we actually did it. Wow, we did it already. Nice. I wouldn't say already, but you know, we already did 2,000 kills on this account. But yo, green logs. Green log Cerberus, man. Okay. Alright, we're gonna stop here at Cerberus for... the foreseeable future, because 2000 KC with a freshly minted green log sounds really freaking good to me. So we're gonna stop here and yeah, sayonara to Cerberus. All right, we did a bunch of prep just now for some Slayer, since I am doing quite a lot of Slayer right now as our grind for the week. So Slaughter bracelets, expeditious bracelets, I got them all. All right, and the heart clue. Oh, unique item though. Sick. Ooh, Runeplate by G. So someone asked me where the Shaman Warhammer collection log slot was, and yeah, it's here, and then I noticed that there's a bunch of super easy stuff that I never got, like Scepter pieces, that's so free, these crab pieces from Recipe for the Disaster, so free. I'm 1 in 33, maybe I'm just super unlucky. Oh, there it is. What the heck? I kill these for tutorial skips all the time, so it's so weird that I've never gotten this before. Oh, top of Scepter, let's go, easy. All right, all of Stronghold Security is now done. Oh, I got it. Hey, that was so fast. Wow. Huh. See, just like that, I filled 5 slots. Okay, that's gonna help a lot because that way I can shoot my can more comfortably. I thought these would work as safe spots, but this skeleton? Nope, it doesn't. I need to kill this for the Brine Saver collection log slot. Oh, I got it! Prepare your PogChamps, first one. Oh my god, that's so rare! Whoa! How much is that? Samurai Dehyde Shield? Isn't that like a gilded rarity? Wait, and a new item, room to play skirt tea? Oh, wow. I've never gotten a D-High shield ever before. Ooh, holy wraps! This is an item that I've already gotten. I actually want to try something. Let's go and try and get some of these for the collection log. It's pretty free. And without ruining kind of like the progression system in... Oh, Obsidian Gate, nice. We got our first Tsar collection lock. Oh, oh my god, whoa. Back to back, basically. Into Obsidian Plate Legs. Holy shit, let's go. Tsar has dopamine. Holy. We still have so much more, too. Let's see. Let's see here. We still have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Wow. Still 8 more items. Alright boys, good luck us. Only one clue today though. Oh, I told you man. Easy slot, boys. Upon inspection, there's a bunch of other super easy stuff I can get done for the log. Like this one, Creature Creation. Super easy. It's like guaranteed drops for these, so. I'm gonna do this real quick, and I think there is some super dumb one like this one. Apparently, I never bought a Graceful Cape, so that's kind of dumb. Okay, let's get a graceful cape, I guess, because we never got those. Boom. Quick background, the Tower of Life. This is a mini game where you can create a homunculus, which if you kill it, it'll drop certain resources. So let's say I want to kill Spideen. I need Red Spire Eggs and Sardines, and killing it will give you a lot of red spider eggs, and that's what I usually do for red spider eggs. It's the fastest way on an Ironman to get them. But there's some other homunculuses that you can kill, and they all drop these satchels. They're just random items that you can get for cosmetic reasons, but they're in the collection log, so. There we go, green satchel done. Took a while. Hey, black satchel done. Now to do some of the harder ones. I gotta kill giant frogs and get a bunch of their legs. Oh, that's not fun. Look at this attack animation, dude. This is how you know this is from legit 2007. They look like Kermit the Frog, man. Oh my god. Did they get rid of the tree yet? Oh, they did. Oh my god, that's crazy. Gold satchel, let's go. Yay. That one didn't take too long. Nice. Cute and disturbing at the same time. Oh, we got it. Hey, the plain satchel. Whoa, dude. Look at this guy's... Look at this guy's movement animation. There you go. 639 slots, though. Looks good. Another green slot, boys. So, there is these free ones here called the Fossil Island Notes. You only need to use Pneumolites to open them. And I have a lot, so this is a perfect time to use them. These notes in the Fossil Island don't do anything important other than just to expand on the lore of the Fossil Island itself. And we just keep trying, right? There we go. One note, just like that. Alright, three slots. This is gonna be like what? Like 10 slots, yeah. Okay, let's see if we get enough Pneumolites for this or not. Oh, there we go. Oh my god, this is so freaking awesome, dude. So free, guys. Holy shit. Dang, that's insane. This is so free. Hopefully I don't run out, man. Please don't run out. I still have a lot. Come on. I feel like I'll finish this before I run out of Pneumolites. Let's go. Is it Destiny? I think it's Destiny. I'm gonna get 10 of these before I run out, right? Right? Five more. Come on. Nice. Okay, sweet. We used like 3,000 Pneumolites and I've already gotten 6, so. Come on. Oh, 7. 3 more to go. 5,000 Pneumolites. Oh, 8. 9? Dude, free? Free, free. Wow, this is so fast. Oh my god. Done. Wow, done. Like 3,000 Pneumolites and we're done. Dude, look at that. The freest thing ever, man. Alright. I guess this is pretty free, the Cam Duzo, but that takes time. This takes time. I'll just do this AFK tonight or something. Oh my god! Double? Okay, I gotta go for back-to-back, but no way! That's like the second or third time I've gotten a double barrels item. Wow, that's the second time, I think, that I've gotten the double barrels since coming back. Wow, that's so cool. Alright, we gotta go for the back-to-back. Oh, what? No fucking way, dude. No way. That's actually a new item. 650. Oh my god, dude. I gained like almost 20 slots today. Let's go, boys. Oh, wow. We're so close to finishing barrels again. 1, 2, 3, 4. Nice. Full Varex is done. Let's go. Okay. Well, we gotta go for the back-to-back, surely. Okay, 16942, 16920. So I used about 22 casts this run, 22 casts. And that is how many chaos runes? 66 chaos runes. Okay, so each barrel's run on average is 247 chaos runes based on this sample size, which is a pretty reliable sample size here. And we only use about 60 to 70 chaos runes a run. We profit by a lot, actually. We still profit 180 or something, so that's still huge. Now the question is, do I finish the last four barrels items in under 2000? What do you guys think? Yes or no? Build hella slots, man. What a highlight. We got a new barrels item. That was sick. And we filled all of creature creation, and we filled all the Fossil Island notes, and we filled this rooftop agility. Damn, I got three green slots, dude. That's sick. So the Camduzo log, we've done a bit before for the hammer, the M. Camendo's hammer, because you can wield it, so it's technically best in slot, but there's some other stuff here too, like the Baronite Mace. So in free-to-play, that would be the best crush weapon available to you. That's 4 tick speed, so same as a rune skimmy, But for us, it's just collection lock slots. So let's go get them. Oh, I got it. Nice. The ancient something something. What's it called? Astroscope. Let's go. Oh, I did it. Ancient treatise. Let's go. All right. All the mining stuff's done. Now to do fishing and killing those golems for the mace. Yeah, let's go. Alright, we're pretty much at the drop rate, but these guys are just not dropping. Thankfully, you can use the cannon here. I've just been utilizing the double shots. Oh, I got it! Yes! Baronite Guard, hell yeah. Just around 200 kills. Where is it? Oh, there it is. Let's go. Give me that. Construct the weapon. Let's go. Hey, there it is. Baronite Mace. Let's get it. And there it is. Camdozao is done. Sweet. That was pretty fun and easy. So, too bad most of these are not that easy anymore. From the miscellaneous side. Alright guys, back on the main progress on the account, which is to get all the purples from the tombs of a musket. We have one left, and that is, of course, the Missouri body. That's gonna be so good to get. Wait, who has a higher range, me or it? Oh, apparently I have a higher range. It can't even hit me from here. Oh, a purple. What is it? Whoa, the ring's actually going up a bit. I think it's probably because of the video that I've made, huh? Oh, come on. That's really... Oh, come on. That's really unlucky. But good thing I prayed mage. So I survived. Mm-hmm. Oh, my days. Here we go. Another ring. Nice. Let's see. Wow, I'm at 13 rings, holy. Nice, the start of the day. Oh, okay, well, probably like my fifth ward or something. Good luck. Oh, 300 KC expert. We're almost at basically 400 total KC though. Oh, no, oh, it's over. Oh my god.
Assistència de Xavi, més cap a la dreta per a Messi, 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 immens Messi, encara 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 Messi, gol, 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 gol.
Oh, apparently I reached 20 mil crafting speed at some point. Here we go. What is the purple? Oh, it's another ring. Let's see. What is it? Oh, another ward. Now the wards are flying in, dude. Here we go. At least give me the pet at this point. Alright, what we got here? Well, does this even count as a purple, guys? You know? Not trying to sound like a bitch, but... I'm on my 15th ring. What we get? No way! The tease is so strong, bro. That's the third leg. I mean, the dupe leg was cool. The dupe leg was cool, but we have gone a third leg, and I don't really need a third leg, so... On the side, we're just AFKing a lot of ours for them blood shards. You never know when you need more, so always good. Oh, finally, a blood shard. Damn. Oh, another blood shot. Yes, let's go. Finally, the RNG is coming back. I mean, we were like only 10 times dry, so I wouldn't be surprised if another 8 of these or something, 7 of these just randomly start popping in. Let's go. Oh my god. Yes, this is what happens when you go 12,000 dry. You start getting 3 blood shards in a single day.